from that short break. Now, this is a segment that I'm very much interested in, because at this point, we are going to talk about value addition. If you want to understand what value addition is, I went and visited a lady called Florence, who has added some value to her pumpkins. To know more of this, just turn the screen. Let's watch what she's saying. Have you ever wondered why some companies sell certain products a little bit expensive more than the others that you just find on the market when you walk into probably your supermarket or a normal market? The answer to that is simple. There is value addition to their product that is a little bit expensive. And today we want to talk to Mrs. Kakande Florence, who is the founder and CEO of Equator Commercial Farming and Processing, specifically focusing on pumpkin. And we see what she's doing with pumpkin. My name is Darren Bartlett, and I want to welcome you to The Business Show. Madam Florence, tell us, how did you come up with the thought of value addition to pumpkins, and what is the history of your company?
We started way back as farmers. We were doing farming, commercial farming, and selling basically for pumpkin, but we were having a network of other farmers. We could join hands and then we market together. But by that time, we had challenges whereby we were selling as we produce with no value addition at all. We found with the seasonal growths and fluctuations, we used to find the income non-stable, and like we chose among the outgrowers, they chose Equator to do the marketing. Mm-hmm. And at the time there was a challenge where I could leave fellow farmers and come to Kampala to Nakasero to market. Then you tell them, we are going to get say per fruit or pumpkin, we are going to get 2,000. We end up in Nakasero, somebody buying it at 500 shillings. So it was not making up. We thought, now if we do value addition, it is going to last for long, because when you produce pumpkin and you just sell it, you will be caught up by the time, because it won't stay on the shelves for long. But with value addition, it can stay even for a year. So that brought me to value addition.
That's how you started the company Equator, and then
We started.
Okay. There are so many things that you could have added value to: bananas, cabbages, name it all. But we would want to find out, why did you choose pumpkin specifically?
Pumpkin is a highly nutritious fruit. When you look at it, it's an indigenous fruit, but it is highly nutritious. So we were looking at it like, if we can give somebody's pumpkin the way it is without losing any nutrient. Because what we do, we chip the whole pumpkin together with a peel, with the seeds and the fruit itself. What we get out is only water. And when you look at the peel, it has the fiber, and that is very, very good for digestion. It's very good for controlling the blood sugar levels. And when we add in the seeds have a rich in zinc, and zinc is good for immunity, it is good for memory, it is good for like controlling the prostate cancer. So we thought, let's have everything in there. And the fruit itself, with its yellow color, it is an antioxidant. It has beta carotene. This is very good for vision. It is good for improving the immune system. And when you look at all what is in pumpkin, you don't want to miss out on anything. That's how we chose pumpkin, with its richness. We are looking at organic pumpkins, because we are not looking at the conventional one because of what is accompanied by the chemical effects. Mm-hmm. As we are looking at it the natural way. So
Is it because I assume The processed one is in powder format, right?
Yeah, it is in the powder.
Anything you add to it that makes it very...
There are no additives. We don't add anything.
Not in terms of chemicals. I mean, in terms of other nutrients that you add to it.
We have several products. That is when we do purely pumpkin, when it has nothing else.
Nothing to it, just pumpkin.
Yes, we have several products. Mm-hmm. Like we have pure pumpkin, that is flour. With that one, you can lick it, you can add it to your meal, you can add it to sauce, you can add it to milk, you can add it to whatever, whenever you're feeling you're taking a meal that is not nutritious enough, you just add the pumpkin powder and you are there. You may even forego the curry powder and add pumpkin. It has that taste. So as you're eating it, you are supplementing. Now, that is a product on its own. We also have another one that is a composite, where we add pumpkin with soya, and then we add beans. There is another one with pumpkin and maize. We keep on adding it to different produce, such that we get different composites depending on the needs of consumers.
All right, Florence, you operate in a very thin market. As a matter of fact, I would say you could be the only person that I know who is processing pumpkins. And that market looks to be thin. What do you think, I mean, how is it faring in the economic environment so far?
It is a thin market because people are not yet sensitized. Once people know the importance of pumpkin, I think everybody needs pumpkin and the market is wide. If somebody out there is growing pumpkin and doesn't know the beauty and how rich and nutritious the fruit is, then somebody may just take it casually. But I feel the market is wide when someone knows when to eat it.
When to eat the pumpkin.
Yes.
You mentioned something very interesting here. You've mentioned about people growing. And I want to understand, how has Equator impacted on people's lives? Apart from you, of course, benefiting from it financially.
We have impacted several other people, because among the outgrowers, we have women, we have youth, and we have several other outgrowers, other farmers. Because now what Equator does, we source out seeds for our farmer groups, and we also source for extension services. We partner with Advocacy Coalition for Sustainable Agriculture to train those farmers in our own inorganic farming. So in so doing, we are impacting them, because we are creating a ready market for the farmers. We are making a positive difference in their lives by getting some income out of what they grow.
Okay, Madam Florence, now the people who are watching you, probably some of them have the pumpkins at their homes, in their gardens. Now, one would imagine, how much do you buy a pumpkin, and how do you actually work to connect such people to benefit from Equator?
Okay. Our way of operation is, we work with groups, where it's better and advisable to work in groups, because we are focusing on organic pumpkins. However, if you are there alone and you are having quantities and you're having the type of pumpkin that we need, then we can work with you. You can call us, we look at your pumpkin, and then we see how we're going to operate. And the price is also dependent on the season, sometimes, and on the size. Sometimes, you know, it is, the season is hyper, then other times it's low, then it can range between 1,000 to 2,000.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a good one. There are so many business people who are watching this show, or people who want to do business in future. Educate us on the importance of value addition to products or services.
With value addition, you're likely to earn more and for longer. Like in my case of pumpkin, not only pumpkin alone, but in my case, like say pumpkin, if you're selling it in its raw form, the way it is, you are limited by time. You are sure if they don't take it at a specific time, mm-hmm. then it is going to be, then it is going to perish, and then the price will also go down because you want it to be bought in a specific period of time. But when you add value to what you're doing, like you get a product out of it, and the product can stay on the shelf, say, for a full year instead of it being
like
there
3 days or 4 days in the market. Mm. All right, someone who is watching you right now could be wondering, like, look, I have a lot of pumpkins in my backyard, probably in my garden, and they want to benefit from you right now. What advice would you give them? How do they join? How do they be part of you so that they could supply you with some of these pumpkins?
Yeah, we get in touch with various groups. Usually we don't want to work with individuals. It's good in groups if they can combine. And then we find a way of how to train them, giving them maybe specific species of seeds. Like when we talk about the pumpkin, you may not just buy maybe foreign varieties, but you are looking at the indigenous pumpkin. So when you are in teams and we come in and train you and we source the extension workers to come and help you do the work, we'll get exactly what we expect. So I would say let those people get in touch with us, let them have their groups, and then we help them to grow organically.
How many groups so far do you have?
No, we are having only 8 groups, on average of 40,
oh,
adding
okay.
up to 320 farmers.
Which has up to 320 farmers mm-hmm. that supply you. Our point here that we've taken away here is that one of the importances of adding value to your product is that you're going to earn more money. And again, the product takes a little bit longer on the shelves. And the example here is that, you know, you can't keep your pumpkins in the raw format for a longer time. But if you've added value to them, say, dry them, mash them, and process them, basically, you're going to make more money. Now, it's important that in your business, on everyday business you do, that you add value to the product, because that's what people look out for. And then you will earn out more. My name is Darren Bartlett. See you next week on the next edition of Making Money. What's a business show without giving you some financial literacy tips? And this time, we want to focus on how you can maintain your spending during this festive season.
Let's be honest. Holiday shopping has the potential to be awful. You have to brave crowded malls, overpriced items, and the same Christmas carols playing on repeat. But your shopping experience doesn't have to be that way. Here are tips to better shopping during holidays. 1. Plan ahead. It would be nice if we were able to shower our friends and family with unlimited gifts, but the truth is that the majority of us have limited amounts of money. Before you even start your holiday shopping, make a gift list and set yourself a budget. That way, you won't fall prey to last-minute splurge purchases. 2. Save fuel and time by shopping online. Avoid crowded shopping centers altogether by doing the bulk of your shopping online. Just make sure that you keep mailing costs in mind and order your gifts far enough ahead of time so that you don't have to pay for expensive overnight shipping. 3. Focus on Mondays, not Black Fridays. Sure, you may find some pretty crazy deals on Black Fridays, but when you factor in fuel you use to drive to the store, the time you spend waiting in the cold out front before they open, and the time spent fighting the crowds and waiting in line to make your purchase, is it really worth it? Think about it. 4. Don't be afraid to buy the same gift twice. If you find a gift that you know several people on your list would enjoy, don't be afraid to buy it in multiples. This cuts down on your shopping time, and if the store is offering any kind of buy one, get the second one at a discount deal, that's even better. 5. Consider buying experiences, not just stuff. Instead of buying material goods that your family members aren't even excited about, consider buying a day or a weekend trip that you can share together. It can make more sense to invest money in creating a family memory that will last forever than buying an item that will have a short lifespan. And 6. Group your shopping trips. If you have to go to brick and mortar stores to do some of your holiday shopping, figure out where all your stores you need to visit are and plan the route that will involve the least driving. Try to get all your shopping done in one fell swoop so that you don't have to keep driving back out to the stores.
In a money market report, we want to see how the dollar fared this week. And also, we want to know how it will close by the end of the week. Thank you so much for staying with us up to this hour as you are tuned in watching The Business Show. Now, before we go and say bye to you, we need to understand that we need to learn one or two things. Now, if you have a business that you're just starting or it's already in the process, you need to understand that you need to be very patient because it's not going to blossom all of a sudden. Now, you have to do what you do a number of times until it becomes a habit and it will become a success. Now, to follow me or my colleague Viola, just follow the handles that are on your screen, and then we want to wish you a good night until see you next Thursday.